12 Castaways, 3 co-hosts, and 1 podcast. This is your host, Pootie, and we are joined by Nofo.
Hi.
Danny.
Miombo.
Levita.
Hello.
And possibly Tim.
Miombo.
All right. We are going to be talking about the new cast for Stranded in Tanzania, which is our 37th season. It's going to start in 3 days. So as with any pre-game podcast, the cast can change last minute. People can get shuffled around. But as of right now, this is our cast. The tribe we're going to be talking about is the Miombo tribe, which will always wear green. This season, we're going with 22 castaways, our largest newbie cast. So we'll be talking about the 11 on this tribe. I guess we can jump right into it with Chelsea.
I don't like her. She it was always mean to me, and she shouldn't have one fan favorite.
Chelsea. This Chelsea is played by Sophie WAW. I'm guessing that's Winners at War. She's 22-year-old female. This is her first ORG. She says that her Myers-Briggs is INFJ, introverted, intuitive, feeling, judging, the advocate.
I would like to intervene here and say that the Myers-Briggs is certified bad science. So I already think that she thinks she's really smart and is actually kind of like surface level smart. Can't wait to see that blow up in her face.
Yeah, Myers-Briggs is like the edgic of psychology.
Great way to describe it.
It's not real science. It's like, what's your sign?
It can be a little bit helpful, but it's not actually scientific in any way.
Yeah, that's a social scientist talking, so we're correct.
Especially when it's like self-diagnosed too. Nate just added this part in. I forgot about this. Her Discord name was Dwayne the Dwayne Dwayne. That kind of made me think this was a dude. Not gonna lie. And the explanation behind it was kind of weird too. Wasn't it like a...
I wouldn't hate having a person cosplaying as a girl for the entire season. I think that'd be kind of funny.
We're bound to get another one. We've had that in the past. But as of right now, we're taking this at face value. Reem says that she reminds her of a not funny Susie.
Yeah, so she seemed kind of, you know, a little more laid back, pretty relaxed, maybe a little more analytical and nice social rather than aggressive social. It's kind of the vibe I got from her.
You know, it's weird. I feel like with most of the women that we cast, like they come across a little more reserved than they end up being when they get into the game. I think that's just from them being more social in general. So I could see that here as well.
Definitely.
She says in her application, she said, "I think you can expect some social gameplay. I love getting to know people and having a good bond with them. I feel like I make friends really quickly in my normal life. But to be clear, this doesn't mean that I won't strategize. And I'd flip if I have to." I think because she hasn't played a game, she doesn't know what she'll do in the game. And because of that, we don't know what she'll do. But I also think that that's the reason she might overplay. That's just a vibe I get.
I think that she'll definitely overplay. From the sounds of it, I mean, anytime you get a first-time org player, they're either going to be like, oh, I'm the secret mastermind and do nothing, and then float to the end and be like surprised they're a goat. Or a lot of times they come in and they're like, oh God, I need to make big moves. And then they just play so hard and totally blow up their spots. And it's fun to watch. And I'm really hoping that that's the version of a brand new org player that we get here.
Yeah. This season, the casting, it was weird because in the past 2 seasons or so, we've had a lot of females that were very interesting. And we did have a lot of females apply. Some of the more interesting ones dropped. So I think we're kind of left with some of the more strategic or under the radar women. So I'm not sure how that will play out.
Yeah, I agree. I definitely see Sophie WAW or our Chelsea as more of an under the radar, maybe to start.
Yeah. Anything else to say about Chelsea, Nofo?
I give her a 6 out of 10.
Okay. That's fair. Let's go ahead and move on to our next Miombo tribe member. Next up, we have Dean, who is played by Pichu's Rat. He's 25 years old. He's a male. I love this application. I don't know why, because I keep confusing him with the French speaking guy. Is he Eastern European? Did I make that up?
He's Canadian.
Okay. Same thing. No. No, I just really liked him. I think he's going to be he reminded me a little bit of like a Randy from Kuril Islands. I think he's a little bit mischievous. He says he's a first-time ORG player. He's Canadian. Thank you. He's bilingual in English and French. Wonder if he'll get on a tribe with... Is he on a tribe with the other French guy?
Not starting.
Okay. That would be interesting if those two link up. We could be having to use Google Translate on the on the live chat. He's a history student. He says describes himself as stoic, witty, and sassy. Self-described intelligent prick. He says, I respect people who play the game, like people who make the game tolerable if it gets stressful, but I absolutely dislike coasters and hate people who wish to play the integrity or dislike the concept of backstabbing. I'm not here to be your friend. I'm here to win. We can all be friends after the show. A little bit of this is not America's Next Top Best Friend going on.
I feel like this is definitely a guy writing straight for your heart, Pootie.
Yeah, I think, you know, he was a little sassy in his DMs with me, too. I think he could be a lot of fun. He's one of my favorites, Dean. I like that he's Dean, too, because he gives off that little like a
douchey.
Yeah, almost like but almost, you know, who he reminds me of is Frank from Venezuela, your original season.
Oh, fuck you. You guys have no clue why I hate him.
I don't think he'll be Frank. I mean, that's like really tall order, but he reminds me of like that likable douche, you know.
Well, Frank was a train wreck in Venezuela. So do you mean like after Venezuela or?
No, like Venezuela, like.
Oh, okay.
Well, really, you know, maybe a little bit more of like, I could see him being a little bit more like a Randy or someone who will bounce around a little bit. Mm-hmm. Whereas Frank was someone who like very much was a control freak. I'm not sure that this is this guy, but mm-hmm. I definitely think he has like a devious side, but is also likable about it.
He definitely has a devious side.
As long as he's Venezuela Frank and not, you know, the ultimate game Frank or whatever. Oh, I hate him.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, comes with the territory of arrogance. I think this cast is going to surprise us. Like, I think there's some people we're not thinking will deliver very much. And I think that they're going to surprise. They all have potential. Obviously, we're casting them. But, you know, some people might be underselling how much they'll deliver.
Yeah. For a little more on Dean, he had quite the story in his interview about how his mom used to babysit kids and he killed somebody's imaginary friend by flushing it down the toilet. So he's definitely a character. I think he's going to be entertaining. I think his confessionals will be fun. And I'd like the Randy comparison a lot.
Yeah, maybe it's just that he reminds me of like Rob or Eric, you know, that kind of like really cynical, funny douche. You know, like a really fun player. Let's put it that way. All right, let's move on to Elizabeth. This is, of course, Rachel from Isolated, played by Shayna. That's her handle, her name. She's a 36-year-old female, mother of four, I believe. Mother of five. Former strip club manager. She lives in Canada and enjoys copious amounts of weed and beer.
I also love copious amounts of weed and beer. Rock on, Elizabeth.
Yeah. Yeah, so
I feel bad for her.
Yeah, I know this rep. This might change. She was a last minute cast for her season, and in Invasion, she went out really early. But I mean, obviously, we saw a lot in her, and then at the reunion, she kind of lit into who was it? She got into a fight with somebody at the reunion. Just like the whole reunion was a complete mess.
Well, I just remember she was drunk for it, and that's why we love her.
Yeah, let's hope we get drunk Rachel here.
I also think she's going to benefit a lot from having the first week and a half or however long she was in Isolated, where she knows the amount of time now that it takes to message people. She knows the amount of time that she needs to be around for the challenges. She's not going to be inactive. And I think that's definitely going to help her. And just understanding the way these games work now, I think that that's going to be very good for her chances here.
Yeah, I love that about a lot of the picks this season. All the Isolated people are people who did not do super well their first time. I mean, obviously, one of them made it very far, but for the most part, they were like not all stars of Isolated. So I think they're going to have an edge here. If you remember, Ziggy, although he was an all-star in Isolated, Ziggy went out first juror. So, you know, I could see a similar arc for some of these people. It is a big advantage having played a similar game. And I think it's an advantage not doing so well, because I think they come into this really hungry to prove themselves. And that usually does pretty well.
Mm-hmm. Well, I see Elizabeth doing well. I think, you know, just because I think because she's seen more of the game than other people. Fuck, shut the fuck up.
Keeping that. Yeah, no, I think she'll do great too. I know she's really hungry for it, and she knows exactly what to expect now. I think her downfall and isolated was just kind of getting a little excluded from groups that were forming, but people thought she was in other groups as a result when she wasn't actually, and that kind of ended up hurting her game. And I think this time she'll be more active from the jump, more aggressive in getting into groups and making sure she has a more solid structure behind her.
Agreed. And I hope that if she does wind up going out, we do get another legendary roast from her.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's just make drinking mandatory.
And let's just hope she'll be able to IM the day she's taken out.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about her.
Yeah, didn't she come back briefly for that comeback challenge and like ripped into people?
Well, what happened was she told me after the eviction had already been posted that she was not able to IM at all after she was nominated.
Oh, God. Yeah, something weird happened with her permissions and everybody just thought she posted the roast and ignored them for the rest of the day. And that was not actually the case.
That's kind of hilarious. I mean, it's terrible, but Nate says high key more iconic. All right. I expect good things this season. This rep is awful. I might change this.
I actually kind of love that she gets an awful rep, though.
Yeah, I think, Nofo, you said, like, you can't get two legends in both series.
Yeah, it would be sad if she got, like, Kelly. If she got Kelly or, like, Janet, that wouldn't fit her.
No, I think it'll be interesting. Let's put it that way. This is an interesting rep. All right, well, let's go ahead and move on to Aaron, who is played by Scott Elias. He is 26 years old. He says he's an experienced gamer with over 100 games, but it's like 10 gauge, so it doesn't count. He compared himself to Wardog, Cochran, and Lacina. Did he really say Lacina in the application?
No, he put the full names for both Cochran and Lacina, so
okay.
I kept it consistent.
He was going to ring my douche alarm for their tenacity, analytic thinking, and chameleon nature, respectively. Did his interview while having dinner with his girlfriend. Oh, I think that says it all.
Sounds like something Joaquin would do.
Reem says, can we get the girlfriend on the other tribe, like unbeknownst to him? Reem, we'll be cutthroat, not here to make friends, not here to float, big drama producer. Yeah, his interview went super well. He was one of the ones, I know it was like a Reem favorite, but he was one of the ones we were looking forward to.
Well, he's very dedicated. Like, he was messaging me like constantly before we interviewed him. I think he's going to do well.
Yeah, he was the one who like hounded you down, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I think he's one of the ones within wedding the first weekend, but I'm honestly really not concerned about his activity, even if he's at a wedding.
He'll be on an 11-person tribe, so I think he'll do fine.
Yeah. So he says, listen, as much as this is a fun game, we're trying to make it entertaining too, right? Yes. He says, people are tuned in. You're podcasting about it. Scott Elias is here to entertain. But while I'm entertaining, there's no one more cunning and no one smarter than me. Oof. Good. We're here for the entertainment and we're here for people who are not wallflowers. Because he's right. At the end of the day, this is a game, you know?
Yeah, I think it'll be really fun. I think Aaron's a good rep for him, too.
Yeah, I think he's one of the standouts, really. When I think about like who I'm excited to see play, it's him and a few others. Reem, this is Reem's like one of her. Reem, I know you have to pick like your friend, but if you didn't know anyone else in this cast, would you be picking him as your winner pick?
Oh, 1,000%.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't think he's going to win, but I think he's going to end up being one of our villains of the season. And I think he's going to be highly entertaining.
I just hope I don't end up hating him. That's the only thing I want. I don't want to end up hating him.
Oh, hating him. Okay. I thought you said meeting him.
It's like, no, I always end up hating the douchey Joaquin types.
The Joaquin type. We have a lot of people. I'm a little higher on this cast every time I review them. I think, too, when we first did interviews, we then took like a month and a half off before we picked back up on this season. So it's a little weird. And that's why I think there's a lot of scheduling conflicts at the start of the season. But I'm hoping everyone's still involved. And I also kind of think maybe some people will have waited so long that they'll kind of explode when the game starts.
I know one of those people.
Yeah, that's the hope anyway. So that's Aaron. I think he'll be fun. Let's go ahead and talk about Jack, who's played by Topher Kev. I actually think his name was like Curve. I don't know. I think I just mistyped that. He's 33. This was a referral from Eve, our recent returnee, one of our winners who recently came in third place on Victory. I'm excited about him because he's old school. I don't know necessarily how exciting he'll be, but I think he's a huge personality. I think he's going to be like a confessional king, which we're here for.
He at least promised to be more entertaining than Eve.
Yes. Well, that's always good. Eve was great in her first season, but wow. Joaquin says, not possible. We stand Eve. I love Eve, but really fell out of it in Victory. I don't know if I hold that against Eve so much, though, because of all the competition there. But yeah, this is definitely a different vibe from Eve. I think this is more of the old school Suckster sense of humor. I don't know necessarily that he'll be the biggest player, but I don't care. I like the humor. He says he teaches improv comedy. He likes to lead with humor. He says he would like to be the gay Ciri, the smoker who got off the couch and tried something brave, and that he'd actually be perceived as the gay Reem, the smoker who got off the couch, got sent back to the couch, and welcomed people to my couch with, dude, you messed up. Yeah, one of our favorite lines from interviews. I think this guy's going to be hilarious. Nofo, you said you liked him because he complimented you. That was your one line.
Yeah, I don't remember what he said about me, but I like that.
This guy gives me huge... We don't have a whole lot of the people like this, but you'll remember Luke, played by Patrick of the White.
Yeah.
From Isolated Season 1, who came in second place. Super... I mean, he was like a low-key player, but hilarious confessionals. Like, legitimately, we would log on just to hear him narrate the season. And that's kind of what I'm expecting from Jack.
Makes sense to me.
Do we have any other thoughts on Jack?
Yeah, I'm not too sure how he'll do overall in the season. I could see him going out in most places. I could see him making really a deep run. I could see him... I don't really know what to expect from his gameplay, necessarily.
I think regardless, he'll make an impact on the season, even if he does go out like second or third. I think he'll still be someone we remember.
Yeah, this is another one I had forgotten about just because the interview was a long time ago, but it has been, I think, will be super entertaining.
Mm-hmm, I agree.
And also, it's worth saying he's one of the older people. This season, we don't have a whole lot of diversity in terms of age like we normally do, but we have a lot of personality differences. Background differences. Let's go ahead and talk about one of our youngest contestants, Karishma, who is played by Charlie. He's an 18-year-old, maybe. Devon from Isolated, of course.
What are you talking about? He's 34.
Yeah. Who?
I'm confused. Who? Who's this?
This is Karishma. Devon.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah. No idea. So, Charlie is someone who... He's a train wreck. I don't know how to explain it. I love his personality. Of course, he's a member of the community. He is a 18-year-old boy in the UK, a crazy boy. He's a very fast typer. That's one thing that will get on everyone's nerve. All I know is that his first season, he was boring. A funny personality, but boring. And then he went on to play all these other orgs where he was insane. And I kind of think he's bringing that energy here.
Yeah, he was a lot more low key. Isolated was his very first org ever. So now he's just coming back with a vengeance, ready to really prove himself because he doesn't think he did that in Isolated.
Reem could speak to his rematch days. Those two had a fight going back two seasons of rematch, I think. Oh, Devon's such a mess in games. I'm thinking he's going to be a mess here. He has to be because he's built this up so much in his head that, yeah.
Yeah, I'm worried he's going to get in his head too much about it. That is something I am a little concerned about. I think he's going to put a lot of pressure on himself here, and I don't know how that's going to manifest.
I am all here for a pre-merge Karishma, like, full-on flame out, like, comes in, burns like a star, makes it to the swap, that. And then it's just immediately, like, everyone's like, fuck no. Like, we are not dealing with this for 30 days. I'm kind of
hoping for, like, a Garrett situation. Yeah, or like Liliana, where it's like, you know, they're probably going to be early merge, or hopefully late pre-merge if they're lucky. But, you know, just like everyone is talking about them all the time, hates them. Somehow they like eke through a few votes and then define the pre-merge with their insanity. That's kind of how I see this going.
So we're definitely going with Garrett Bugs for the stranded coin name, right? Like, that's what we're calling it.
Yeah, that'll be the unofficial name. Maybe we'll have a conversion tool. Maybe at some point Garrett will come in and offer Garrett Bucks in exchange for stranded coin. So he says in his application, "I don't have much of a filter. I know how to uphold a social game." Exit out. "But when it comes to sarcasm dragging people, if it's a valid time and opportunity, you will catch me doing all of it. Not trying to ruin my game through, though, obviously, yeah, right. But even if the entire cast was big egos and big players, I can't stop sounding like someone who has 10 personalities and switches between them because of a hormone imbalance."
That last part's definitely true.
Yeah, that was the only true part of the whole thing. I don't know that he has different personalities, though. I mean, he's kind of the same personality. He's almost like a overly hyper little brother that he'll definitely get on people's nerves, right?
Oh, most likely.
Yeah. Let's see
what, but he is smart. He is intelligent. He can think strategically. I just don't know if he can like keep hold it in sometimes.
Well, I think there's two ways this will go. He'll either be trying to make a big name for himself after his disappointing performance in Isolated, or he'll be so focused on trying to do well here that he'll kind of float into the background. I can't see that happening, but certainly it's a possibility.
My prediction is that Karishma is playing for cover star and fan favorite, not playing for the win.
I hope so.
That's always a train wreck to see, though, so that'll be fun. I don't think we'll probably end up hating that, though.
Yeah, especially like a lot of these people are new or older. They're going to be like, what the fuck? I don't know. It could be fun. All right, let's go ahead and move on. Yeah, I think it's also that's a rep that I want to not go to waste. You know, we have a couple of those where we're like, oh, man. And sometimes they do. Like Angelina went to waste. That's why we're reusing her here.
Tune in tomorrow night when we review the reuse of Davey.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's go ahead and talk about the next player. Someone who I know Reem has been waiting for us to talk about. Missy, who is played by Issa, a 21-year-old male, confusingly. So, Issa, am I saying Issa right?
I always thought it was Issa, but I don't think we've ever had to say it out loud.
Is it not short for Isaac?
See, I was thinking like Isabel. We're all saying it different. Anyway. So,
it's Missy now.
Yeah. So Missy is Reem's friend and someone who has been applying for Stranded for a very long time, since Reem's season ended and she told him about it. He kind of got pushed down the road because Victory happened, and then for some reason he didn't play Isolated.
Reem was in Isolated.
Oh, right, that's right. So then Reem was in Isolated, so he couldn't play that. So finally this is his chance, like a year later. And he has been obsessed with playing, so we're very much looking forward to Missy. He says he's been counting down the days of the season for probably 4 months. I think a lot longer than that. Spectated Isolated Invasion. As well as knowing Reem, I think that's going to give him a little bit of a leg up, but we'll talk about that in a second.
Yeah, I agree.
He compares himself to Kelly Wentworth, Sandra, and Michaela Bradshaw. I don't know if he'll deliver on those. That's a pretty big, that's a pretty tall order. But I do think he'll be maybe the Michaela. That might be more accurate.
Michaela. Yeah, I definitely think Michaela, not so much Kelly or Sandra. He is very strategic, but he's prone to outbursts when he gets frustrated with people.
He's your friend?
Yeah, love it.
I've seen him go off on people in tribals, so I don't know.
Reem's building her evil army for the next All-Stars.
Oh, he'll cut me. He does not trust me whatsoever, and I don't trust him.
So, what is this? Who wrote this? Gay blonde frat boy queen with glasses. Who wrote that?
That is part of how he described himself during the interview.
Okay. He's a college student majoring in hospitality and tourism. Used to work with Reem. Reem describes him as a messy queen, extremely ambitious and competitive. He's here to win. And he's certainly done his research. Can't wait to see this fire in Stranded. Yeah, I think he might have a little bit of Devon syndrome. I could totally see him overplaying. But I think he'll be a better player than Devon. I'm going to predict We didn't do predictions. Maybe we'll do that at the end.
Those two are going to go head to head. I don't see them getting along.
No, we put them on a tribe for a reason, especially since Devon is not a fan of Reem, too. Not that Missy will mention it, but...
Well, they're roughly the same age. I think that Missy will probably relate a little better, but I do think he'll get under Missy's skin. But Missy is highly intelligent. So I think Devon might end up being in Missy's army. I really don't know how it's going to end up, but I'm curious to see it.
He says in his app, I think I would actually be portrayed as a lying, persuasive bitch, honestly, and I'm fine with it, but also a loyal social butterfly to my allies. If season 20 of Heroes versus Villains would be remade, I would defiantly be the villain, hands down. I know that's supposed to be definitely. I think, yeah, I mean, we purposely put him and Devon on the same tribe because we know that's a train wreck.
I think the thing that I'm most excited about, most important thing here, is that Issa, Missy, sat through and watched an entire season of Isolated and spectated, kind of knows the humor that we use in the games, has an idea of what to expect and what the challenges are. So I think that he's going to be super prepared.
Just knowing the challenges is going to give Devon and probably Issa a big advantage. I'd also say Brittany and Rachel, but I don't know as much.
Yeah, I agree. We have quite a few people on this cast who have listened to more of the season podcasts than maybe we have in the past, but not as much as Missy has.
Yeah, but we don't really ever talk about how the challenges work.
Exactly. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, I was gonna say this cast has done their research, which will be interesting. I kind of think, I mean, we certainly have our train wrecks here, but I do think it's going to be a more strategic season overall.
For Missy, I see maybe like early, mid-jury.
I was thinking that too, the Reem position.
Yeah.
My prediction is I think he's going to do fine pre-merge. I do think Missy is going to make it to merge. But when he gets to merge, something is going to flip in his brain and he's going to go piss off the wrong person with his loud ass mouth, and then he's gonna go right out the door.
Right.
And that's when we'll get to meet him on the jury.
Yeah, that's really about the point where loud mouths like you and I when we leave. So yeah, I see that.
But honestly, I mean, the cover is more important than the $100.
Some people play for fan favorites, some people play for the win.
Yeah. So let's go ahead and move on to Lauren, who is played by Ash Torres. 25-year-old female. Not one of our top picks.
Yeah, isn't this the one we thought was boring until we picked a fight with her at the end?
Yes. I'm going to need someone to pull up that rant.
Got it.
So this is our old school ORG player from FGC, which for the youngins out there is like Survivor Sucks' gay cousin. It stands for Forum Games Central. And they were like really overly positive, whereas Survivor Sucks was like kind of bitchy. So that being said, I think she'll at least have a lot of experience. And it's always fun to get old school players in Stranded, because Stranded's kind of a throwback, or at least a mix of both worlds. She compares herself to Brenda Lowe, Kim Spradlin, Sophie Clark, hoping that the season doesn't have a bunch of betas. That was my only favorite line. I actually, you know, her application was not bad. It was really just her interview that was terrible. I said, I get villain vibes, but I'm not sold. In her application, she said, I get along with alpha personalities. The types I clash with are quiet ones who can't make a decision. I feel like when people are too reserved, I have to speak up for both of us. So two things helped her case. Well, three things. Number one, she's a female. So we're always looking for a differing perspective. But we did pass on some females this season. So the things that boded well for her were that she really disliked quiet players, which led me to believe that she was not going to be someone who plays in the shadows. Her personality didn't tell me that, but I really got like Stephanie vibes, where we didn't cast her. We almost didn't cast her because her interview was so terrible. But she has like a villain thing going on that I think she might become a big villain in the season.
Yeah, part of me kind of got the impression that she was so self-assured that she'd be good at this that she didn't even need to bother giving us answers.
Yeah, it was an awful interview. I mean, awful. Like, we were trying to get something out of her and she wouldn't bite.
Not until the role play.
Yeah, so finally Nofo gets on and is like, but pick a fight with me. How would you fight in the game? So she writes this response to him. I'll read it to you. It says, he said something like, I don't like you. And she says, I don't like you either. And I should have voted your pesky, boring, coattail riding ass off when I had the chance, but I didn't. And I let you get away because I know this is all you have. You sit at home jacking off to bestiality porn and eating pretzels with no life in your parents' basement. So I felt sympathy for you. But big mistake. You better do whatever you can to win the next immunity because I have an HII I'll use so strategically to send you out of here. You won't know what hit you. And I'll be calling your local suicide watch when it happens. You know, at least she played ball when we asked her to throw some insults at us.
I mean, I'm not going to lie. That's more than we get in like 50% of interviews. So I'm excited. Yeah. I hope somebody pisses her off. And the fact that she's with Davon on a tribe, like, God, I cannot wait for Davon to just push her buttons and like make her have to use something like that.
Yeah, she might be someone who's all talk, but she did say she hates wallflowers and she's always aligning with people who are big personalities. So at the very least, she's someone who's not looking to get out big personalities, which is always a plus.
This will definitely be the messy tribe.
That's what Nate says. This tribe has all the annoying people. Yeah, kind of.
Nate just doesn't like this tribe because none of them responded to his emails.
Oh, yeah. All right. So that was number 9. We got two more to go. Let's go ahead. Yeah, Issa did. Yeah, right away. Let's go ahead and talk about Tommy. Tommy's one of my absolute favorites and one of the people I'm super excited about this season. He's played by Scotty 33 Ball. He's 38. So I think that he's the oldest person this season.
I think so.
He played his first org this summer. He joined a Discord to practice for Stranded. He won. He was also funniest player. Not hard to win a Discord game.
Yeah, he was playing a bunch of 15-year-olds, I think he was saying.
Yeah, but I do love that he did it specifically to practice for Stranded.
I will say that there is something just like a little disconcerting about a 38-year-old hopping onto a Discord game with 14-year-olds to beat them in Survivor. That just like, it sits with me and I'm like, damn, you're a fucking savage. Like, just dunking on 14-year-olds.
I don't think he knew they were going to be 14.
He didn't know how this worked. He assumed it was going to be like Stranded. So he coaches high school basketball and works in sales, which makes that last part even funnier, that he coaches 14-year-olds and just dunked on them in Discord. So he says he rented a cabin in the woods to play 8v8 Survivor with a bunch of friends. Oh, he's one of those.
Yeah, I get big Matt vibes from him.
Yeah, dude, too. That's a good comparison. He says, I would like to see how I do in a manipulation lying game. Am I going to be up all night second guessing or just nail it and live with that decision? I fear the former. It's definitely going to be the former. Am I as likable as I think I am? I work in sales, have a lot of friends, but easily could land in a group that thinks that I might not be all that in a bag of chips. So can I alter myself to fit in? Will I need to? So many questions. I think I just really like him. I don't think he'll get left out. I think he's going to be one of the better players. I think he's going to, if you're already second guessing that you'll overplay, you will definitely overplay in the game because generally you become more paranoid when you play. I think he'll do like a JC Matt type game. Those like assured older males usually do pretty well.
Yeah. I definitely think he'll do a good job. He seems just it's very easy for him to get his personality across through how he writes. And I think we all saw that in his interview. And I think his cast will see that too.
Yeah. Tommy's like the perfect rep for him too.
Poor Shuggy.
Oh, yeah. Cause everybody can hear Shuggy coughing in the background. How well do I think he'll do? I think he'll do really well. He really reminds me of, and this is going to be a deep dive. I don't think anybody lurked that season, but LJ from Socotra, maybe Nofo or Nate will remember. He was like an older guy, a dad who was like really level-headed, really likable, and just played a good game. And that's kind of how I see him. I think he's going to be a little more entertaining than that, though.
Yeah, because I don't remember him.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. I instantly, when we talked to Scotty, we really liked him. And he was someone who stood out. You know, I think he's going to be a lot of fun. I do worry about the fact that he's older than most of the people in this season.
But he did show that he doesn't have a problem connecting with younger people, considering he dunked on all the 15-year-olds and got all their votes except for one.
Yeah, and he coaches basketball and for high schoolers, so
he'll be able to pull off the Steve Buscemi, hello, fellow kids, I am also a kid.
Yeah, he won't be like, what's Tic Tac? Like I would. I mean, he's only like 7 years older than me, so it's not like he's ancient or anything. Yeah, no, I'm just excited to see him play. He was one of my standouts. So Let's go ahead and move on to the final member of this tribe. One of the people
I'm going to go first because I have to leave. I hate Vince. Well, no, I like Vince, but he's a weirdo and I don't know anything about him. And I think he's going to go home first. Bye.
No for signing off.
Vince is 22-year-old male, played by Superior, which I guess is a play on Superior. He describes himself as an org junkie who has played about 6 years across many platforms, but mainly Discord now. If you're a fan of both, you're going to have to help me with this, Levita.
Danganronpa.
Thank you. And Pokemon franchises. Reem says, I like this dude. He's a weirdo 100%, but conversation with him seems to flow from what I read. I think the castaways won't know what to do with him. He says in his application, when people don't like me or have something against my personality, I'm usually something along the lines of just being too much to handle. I guess I get too excited when I meet new people. Then when I realize I've inadvertently crossed a line, I get in the habit of working a little too hard to rectify the misstep and just come across as petty, clingy, or annoying. Yikes. And
Tim also said that he's hosted Vince before and he has this weird energy that makes people just not like him, but it's not really his fault.
Yeah. I mean, like, he's definitely socially awkward. He's very much Vince. he's going to be a train wreck. He could actually be the person that we think Devon will be. I could totally see him being like this person that we are absolutely praying survives, but everyone can't stand. Can we mention the furry thing?
I mean, he talked about it in his interview. That's why I said he was a huge fan of the Pokemon franchises. But he really likes toxicity. We can leave it there.
Gary has a friend. Yeah, we finally found it. Gary's going to be pissed that we didn't ex-nay him from the cast based on his hobbies. Yeah, this guy's a weirdo. I love it, though. I'm here to see what happens with that.
Yeah, I think he'll be super entertaining for as long as he's there, at any rate.
I'd love that he says he knows he's annoying and clingy and he knows all his flaws and doesn't know how to fix them. I don't know. At the same time, I think he's really likable, too. I think he's going to be a standout on this tribe. Honestly, going over some of these people, it's a lot better than I thought it was, this cast. I was kind of low on them this morning, but we have some gems here. I think we're going to see some people step up like we didn't think they would.
Yeah, I think it's a good group. I don't know if I could pin an obvious first boot unless, people just don't show up. But I think it could get, at least on this tribe, it could get really interesting really quickly.
My hot take is I think that Sophie is the first boot off this tribe.
You mean Chelsea?
Yes, Chelsea. Sophie W-A-W, a.k.a. Chelsea.
Yeah.
I can also see that.
Yeah, I think that's not a bad take. I think
she just seems like the least, I don't want to say the least entertaining, but probably the least entertaining and smallest personality, most forgettable out of these people. And I think that would probably set up pretty well for a first boot.
I think it's just going to come down to activity, like it always does. We cast these things pretty well. We put in people that we want to watch. So it usually comes down to activity level. And I expect that to go this way. And also, if someone's active but boring, they usually make it far, unfortunately, for us. So we're hoping that's not the case. But I think that's not a bad take, Chelsea.
Or Ash.
Yeah, I was going to say, I would think maybe someone like Lauren or Kelly might fill that role, too.
Basically, we think a woman's going to go first.
I hope not. I hope we're wrong. But yeah, that's kind of what I think. I don't know. I think because they weren't the first ones to respond and they're not always the most, they're not the ones that have reached out a lot, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So they're not on the forefront of my mind like Dean is, like Tommy is, people who have repeatedly reached out to us. So there's that. That being said, I think that there are some people on the other tribe that will do very well. And I don't think, hopefully, they'll be in danger on that tribe. So that is the Miombo tribe. I think this is going to be a fun group. I don't even know if I see them losing challenges. I could be totally wrong. But for whatever reason, I feel like this group is a strong group.
Definitely possible. But
I agree, are we allowed Pootie.
To talk about how the first round's going to go, or are we saving that?
No, let's preview it.
Okay, because they're going to have to vote somebody out right away. There's no win in challenges. Both tribes get a tribal.
Yeah, we have 22 people. We got to cut some fat. Last season, did not play well when we had the men win the first three challenges and basically skip the first week of the game. So we've learned from that mistake, and we're making everyone play the game right off the bat, hopefully making both tribes messy, unless it's an obvious first boot. But either way, everyone's got to get their hands dirty.
So that should definitely make for an exciting first round.
Hopefully. We're going to have a lot of firsts this season. we're dipping our toes in the currency waters with Stranded Coin, making its debut this season. We have some fun twists planned with that. Again, it's our largest newbie cast, so we have a lot of people to talk about, and hopefully a lot of people that will join us afterwards.
It's looking good.
All right, well, I think that's going to do it for our preseason podcast of this tribe. We will talk to you guys again tomorrow, where we will preview the other half of the cast, the Nigiri tribe. We have to look up how that's said, too. Pronounced. But we're going to talk about those other 11 new players. So I think that's going to do it for us. This is Pudi signing out.
Bye.